As we already said before, direct map and fully associative caches can be considered to be just special cases or set associative caches. So for example, a direct map cache is actually a one-way set associative cache. And a fully associative cache is an n-way set associative cache where n is equal to the number of lines. For all these caches, the address that the processor supplies is broken into the offset, index, and tag components. The number of offset bits is the number of bits that we need to tell us where in the block size we are. So it's log 2 of block size. The number of index bits is log 2 of the number of sets we have. In a direct map cache, that is the number of blocks we have. In a fully associative cache, that's 1, so log 2 of that is 0 and we have no index bits. And the tag bits are the remaining bits. When you're trying to figure out which bits are the index bits, we actually need to know which bits are the offset bits too, because knowing that we have, for example, 3 index bits doesn't really tell us whether they are here or here or here. That depends on the offset bits. So make sure that when you are determining these bits, you do it in that order. First figure out how many offset bits, then the next so many bits are the index bits, and then the rest is the tag.